lights, camera, and more lights. Welcome to the shiny new studio. Today, we're flicking the switch on all things illumination, from nudging those parent positions to diving headfirst into the magical mysteries of light falloff, light transmission, and much more. This video is your personal flashlight through the dark alleys of After Effects. Plus, we'll unlock the secret of the advanced 3D renderer and nail that trendy flat 3D style everyone is talking about. So put on your sunglasses and get ready to see your project lit literally in a whole new way. We'll kick things off with a neat trick that will give you precise control over how light affects individual layers in your composition, letting you art direct the mood by adjusting each light's color and intensity. So in this composition, I've already separated the layers using my free script, One Click Parallax. The link is down below. But even after dispersing these layers in 3D, things feel a little flat. Well, this is because there are just flat cards positioned in 3D space. However, we can dramatically enhance the scene, making it feel more cinematic and immersive by strategically placing a few lights exactly where we want them. And here's how it works. So I'll start by going to the end and I'll add a new point light. I'm going to use the default settings here. You can cast shadows if you want. I don't think we need them in this case, so I'll just dismiss this and click OK. Now, I actually want to marry this light to the wild layer over here. So I'll hold down Shift and I'll shift parent it to the wild layer, which makes this light jump to the relevant position. Then I'm going to hold down Control Command on the windows and click again on the parent peak whip icon to dismiss the linking. And now I have a light that I can control, but I know that the starting place is exactly where I need it. So if I'll go back to the beginning, this is how it looks. A little bit boring, but at least I got the light where it needs to be. So instead, I'm going to parent it to the camera. And this means that it's going to move with the camera, starting with a very dramatic black, almost no light at all in the scene, and then pulling off with the camera as it is traveling or dolly out, which again, looks really nice. But we can make it even better. Again, we are losing a little bit detail over here where this iguana is close to the camera. So let's create a new light. This time I'm going to press Command, Option, Shift, Control, Alt, Shift on Windows and the letter L to create a new light from the keyboard. I'll use again a point light. This time I'll reduce the intensity to 40 and click OK. And I'll do the same thing that I did before. So I'll shift parent this to the layer that I want it to light. And now I can use the 3D gizmo and just drag it until it looks good. Let's do another one, this time lighting the sky. So I'll create a new light. This one will be a blue color. I'll set the intensity to 50%. And again, I'm going to hold down Shift and parent it to the sky, which is the last layer over here. And then I'll hover on top of the 3D gizmo, or I can use the properties panel and just adjust the position of the light, which in my case, I think it's a little bit easier. So let's bring it over here. And of course, we can play with the intensity however we like. So this looks really cool. But as you can probably notice, we have some dark areas here. So to solve this issue, I can select all of my lights and convert them to adjustment lights, which works exactly like adjustment layers. So we can easily determine which one of the layers will be affected from the lights. I'll start with light number 2. I'll place it above the iguana because this is what I want it to light. And then I'll take light number 3 and drag it just above the sky. And finally, I'll take light number 1 and place it above the wild title. And as you can see, these rocks, which are in a different 3D position, are not going to be affected from it. And now I have exactly what I want. So let's preview it again from the top, and we have exactly the desired result. So this simple method can and will help you. Next time, you need to control and art direct the way lights affect layers in the composition. The next trick will help you to achieve more physically accurate lighting, especially when the light interacts with semi-transparent materials like glass and water. To illustrate, I've chosen a clip I've captured from the roof of the new Tate Gallery back when it was still open for the public to do this. Over the River Thames, you can see I've placed the Thames logo inspired by the classic TV opener. Some of you might remember it. I've already tracked the scene, animated the logo rising upward, and added three light around it. And I'm also placing a shadow catcher layer on the river surface. Now, to achieve those attractive long shadows, position your primary light high above the layer. You can then use additional lights to gently fill in darker areas, as demonstrated here. Now, at this point, everything aligns with the London's iconic grey weather, but the shadows on the water still seem off and the logo itself appears overly dark. To enhance the realism, we can open the material options of the layer that basically casts the shadows and adjust the light transmission settings. This allows the light to pass through the object, altering the shadow's color on the reflective surface below. And you can adjust it according to the surface that catches the shadow. So I'm just going to tweak it to, I guess, around 60% in this case. Now, for further refinement of shadow darkness and softness, you can select the light that casts the shadows and then use the properties panel to blend it perfectly into the environment. See the difference? It is huge. The scene now feels much more authentic, and it's all thanks to tweaking a few sliders in the material options and light settings. Now, one important note, this method works exclusively with the classic 3D renderer, so keep that in mind when setting up your projects. Next, let's explore a comp I created a couple of years ago when After Effects became significantly faster thanks to multi-frame rendering technology. This particular comp uses the Cinema 4D renderer, allowing me to enable Draft 3D for real-time playback. Now, I've already positioned four point lights strategically along with a parallel light to brighten the area near the extruded logo. While it looks decent, we can make it even more visually compelling by leveraging some unique lighting features. So I'll start by adding a new spotlight, ensuring it is casting shadows. Now, typically, pointing a spotlight requires managing both its position and the point of interest, which can be cumbersome. To simplify this, I prefer turning off auto orientation by going to Layer, Transform, Auto Orient, and selecting Off. Now, I can easily position the light using the 3D gizmo without worrying about an extra axis, much like using a one-node camera. Once satisfied with the spotlight placement, I'll refine its attributes using the light options in the Properties panel. I'll start by setting the falloff to Smooth, and then adjusting the radius and fall-off distance until it covers precisely the desired area. Alternatively, you can experiment with the more physically accurate inverse square clamp setting, though Smooth provides more direct control. As usual, changing the light color can dramatically alter the scene's mode, so let's warm it up a touch. However, we are losing some drama here, so let's fix it by selecting the parallel light, and then I'll press T to reveal its intensity, and drag the value this time into the negative range. And this creates an effect of pulling light out of the scene, darkening specific areas. So you might need to revisit your key light, the spotlight in this case, and adjust its intensity to balance things out. I think this looks really nice. So make sure to preview these adjustments this time without Draft 3D so I can see the full quality result, which is noticeably more dramatic, more dynamic, and visually engaging. The last trick is the simplest yet often overlooked. This technique applies specifically to the advanced 3D renderer, which by default provides built-in shading for 3D layers, even without any added lights. While this default shading is attractive, sometimes you might prefer a flat, stylized 3D look, like in social ad promoting an expensive Steam deal compared to the bargain I'm offering you right now. So let's quickly achieve that flat look by adding a new ambient light this time and set its intensity to 100%. Instantly, all shading disappears, leaving us with perfectly flat colors on all layers and models. Now, if this is too flat, you can introduce an environment light and dial back its intensity to suit your needs. So next time you want clean, flat 3D style, just throw in 100% ambient light. It's incredibly quick and simple. And that's it. You've officially become my director of light. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please like and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already done so. So make sure to keep on shining, and I'll see you again in the next one.